Summer forest party.
Tiki, why in the world did you call us together?
So early. Well, because I decided to have a summer forest party for everyone.
Another party, but don't you think the last one was, well, to put it bluntly, a total bore fest? What makes you think this one will be any different?
That is so the best. This one is going to be the best party that you ever...
Would you look at those pretty blossoms?
Aren't you listening to what your king is saying?
Wow, look at these beauties!
Babu, you will be taking note of this. This summer's forest party will be the bestiest party in history. And then I'll be the greatest king in the whole winding world.
Sire! Yes, sire!
Please stop calling me sire. I am the greatest king.
Sounds good, sire.
I said calling me greatest king!
Hey, Tiki, with all these blossoming flowers, it's the perfect time to host a summer party.
I knew you'd come around.
Hello? Who's that?
It's me!
Oh, hi, Bossley. How are you?
A big client of mine has ordered 100-year-old Sephora japonica tree. I need one of those before the end of the day. You get me that tree or else. You can forget about the rest of your quota for today. But if you don't get me that tree, you're fired!
But, boss, hey, what? Oh. 100-year-old Sephora japonica tree. Where in the forest? I remember seeing it somewhere. I just can't remember where it was exactly. What a boring challenge. Hold on, I saw one of them the other week, I'm sure. It's gotta be here somewhere. Who's that laughing?
Bramble, quit messing around. Just carry them.
Sorry, bro.
What are they up to? It's curious. Maybe it's a shindig. Perfect. Last time they had a party in the spring, and I was cutting down loads of trees. Let's see. A Sephora petal? Ooh. I knew you were around here somewheres. Now you guys have fun. Meanwhile, I'll get on with chopping that 100-year-old beauty down.
Everybody coming here and drinking juice.
Oh, it's not juice.
Don't be grabbing.
Pew. Pew.
Pour me another.
I want another cup.
Yeah.
And you'll be wearing this mask for the rest of your life.
Everybody listen to Greatest King ever. This party is open!
Hey there! Happy!
Lagervik! Lagervik! Now what do you want? There won't be any logging, okay?
That's right!
It's not like that. I'm not cutting trees. You just presume the worst. That's not neighborly of you.
So why are you here, then?
I thought you might invite me to your party. I was really hoping...
Hoping that we'd fall for your tricks.
Here. Last spring, we invited you to come to our flower-smelling party, but the whole time you just tried to catch us.
Come on, guys. That's behind me now. I'm sorry. Anyway, you know what they say. Keep your enemies closer.
If Lager Vicky wanted you attending our party, then as the greatest king of the forest and the whole big winding of world, I say, why not?
Oh, really? Your Majesty, thank you so much. Thank you, thank you.
Have more.
Yeah, Bramble, awesome, bro.
This tree is a beast. I need to think of a way to lure those animals away before I begin. But how exactly? Come on, Vic. Think. Think.
You go, bro. Yeah. What's up?
Hey, look. Look at Vic.
What? Why do you think he's sitting there, bro?
I have no idea.
Let's go ask him, yeah?
Sure.
Huh?
What's on your mind, Logger Vic?
Well, been a long time.
Are you feeling a bit lonely?
Is that it, Vic?
Oh, don't cry.
All you gotta do is give up logging.
Huh?
Then we can be friends.
Logger's not really me. It actually makes me feel bad. But I need to survive. We humans have to work. But do you know what's frustrating me? I've been living in this forest for years, but I have not one friend. Woe is me. I really envy you.
Well, if you weren't a logger, I think we would have been best friends all along. The choice is yours, Vic.
Exactly. Logging aside, you're actually pretty cool, Vic.
What? Huh? Do you mean it?
Yeah.
Do you guys really think of me as your friend?
Of course. Quit that logging. You can become our bestest friend.
Yeah, you heard him. We'll be friends forever. Oh, it's gonna be so great.
So, I, Logger Vic, declare that I'm not gonna be a lumberjack ever again.
Hey, Logger Vic. You want to play this slingshot game with me? I'll go first.
Oh my goodness, that slingshot is... please, let me go first, please.
Okay then, you first. Hiya, allow me.
I'm really scared!
Such a guy, baby!
My nosey
nose, Ernie, come on! Oh, come on! Let's play this game now! Yeah? Hey, Vic, which mask do you want? Yeah, I choose this one. Don't you think it's cute, huh?
Yes, they're being so nice to me. I need to stop them from putting on that mask. Right.
What?
This one won't suit you. I'll get another one.
Vic, watch out!
It's stuck.
That's weird. How did the mask get stuck to his butt?
Rebel! Don't just stand there. Help me get this thing off!
Oh! One, two, three!
Hi, Vic here.
I know! I called you! Did you find the tray?
Well,
hello? Well, did you get the tray?
Sorry, not quite yet.
Excuse me? Not quite yet? What have you been doing? I won't be paying you a single penny for any of the work you've done this month!
Hey, Logger Vic! Look at this! We saved the last juice just for you!
Friends over money. That's what I say. Well, my new philosophy anyway. Save some of that juice. A gift from the forest.
Got a dang old letter for Logger Vic. Letter for Logger Vic. Logger Vic. You have a letter. Open up, Logger Vic.
All right, all right. I'm coming. Huh? Huh? Oh, so rude. Wake me up and run off. What's this? It's addressed to me. I'm surprised people still use the postal system. Let's see what it says. Dear sir or ma'am, nice touch, formal. I am happy you received this letter. I have lived in the city my whole life.
I have always wanted to go to the forest and spend time in nature's beauty. Unfortunately, I'm confined to a wheelchair and I fear my dream may never come true. I wanted to ask if you could send me something from the forest. Thank you very much. Yours, Carl.
Poor kid. I've got to send him something to make him happy. But what? What can I send him? What? I'll send him a postcard with a picture of the forest on it. Look at these ones. Hey, man, how much for this one?
80 cents.
80? That's too much. Excuse me. I've got to check to see how much money I've got left. 60, 70, and 3. 73 cents. Not enough. Sorry, man. Maybe next time. Hand painting's more meaningful. Ah, boy. Not exactly a forest, though. I don't know what to do. I've got to think of something. Come on. But what else can I do? That'll do it. All right. Hello, baby. Open with caution. My favorite comic book when I was a child. And there it is. He's most definitely gonna like this. All right, who could that be? Hello, Vic here.
Vicky, this is Mom.
Hi, Ma. It's great to hear from you. How you doing?
I'm okay, but I miss you. It's been months since the last time you called us.
I'm so sorry. I've been working, Mom.
I remember our neighbor's son, Frank. He's busy, but always visits his parents.
My cutout!
My little Vicky, we really care about you.
Come back.
Vicky! Honey, are you still with me?
Get back here! Wait!
Bramble, catch!
They look so beautiful and juicy, don't they?
What can I say? When it comes to fruits, I'm sort of a genius.
Get it off me!
Briar! Bro, are you okay?
My head. What happened? Huh? What's this? Is it just pink?
Beautiful! Brian, let me look.
No, you don't.
Let me look at it, bro.
Your clumsy hands may break it.
I just want to look at it.
No, I said no.
Brian!
Bramble, look there. Is that honey?
Honey? Where is it? I don't see any honey. Huh? Where'd he go?
Let's see. This is incredible. Wow. Amazing.
Where'd it go? I've got to find it. Where in heck could it be?
Cool.
It's Briar. I wonder what he's holding. Oh. That's my cutout in his hand. Thank goodness he found it for me. Hey, Briar!
Huh? Logger Vic? Huh? What's going on?
Nothing much. Thank you for finding my paper cutout. Can I have it back?
Huh? I have no idea what you're talking about.
Huh? But I saw you with it! Give it back to me! Oh, Briar!
Whoa. Stop! Fine. I admit that I just found it. But you can't prove that it's actually yours.
That is called a paper cutout.
A cutout?
Right. Pretty, isn't it? My mother taught me when I was just a boy. I got a letter from a young lad who wants to see the forest. But alas, he lives in the city. And he's in a wheelchair. I thought that paper cutout would be a really good present for him. It has people, the forest, and animals on it. But then it blew away. Briar, will you give it back to me? Please?
Here.
Great.
Hang on. I need you to make a promise. You'll quit logging.
Well...
How about that?
All right, Briar. You have my word.
Here.
Thank you. Thank goodness.
Yeah!
Oh.
Yeah! Yeah, I got it!
Huh? Uh-oh.
I'm so sorry. I didn't know it meant so much to you. I didn't mean to destroy it. Briar, what am I gonna do? Hey, Vic, I'll give you something else to make it up to you. Hey, Briar, do we have anything?
I don't know.
There. It's all my fault! I should have ruined it! I'm such a loser!
Huh? Whoa!
Hey, bears, I figured out what to do for the kid now.
Oh. Wow, I sure can pick him.
When I was young, my mom also taught me how to cut leaves. She picked colorful ones and cut out different shapes to make a barbola. It's gonna be so gorgeous.
Those scissors. These things are so sharp. Bramble, this isn't a toy. You could hurt yourself. By the way, how do we make a barbola?
I forgot. You guys haven't done this before. Right, I'll teach you how to cut the leaves.
Huh?
Alrighty, just watch me. We'll cut it into shape, like so. Isn't that pretty?
This is fun.
Oh, be careful. Don't hurt yourselves, okay?
I'll have a try. There. Huh? Needs more cuts.
Yeah.
Okay, the barbola is done.
Am I dreaming? I can't believe we made such a beautiful barbola.
Look, Vic, you're the hero.
Yes, you are.
Well, thank you. Hey, but we did it together. This barbola we made of the leaves in the forest demonstrates the beauty of nature. It's wonderful. It'll make him feel like he's here. It's like the best gift ever.
Yeah, that's right. This is the best gift ever. I bet he'll be super happy when we give it to him.
Let's go send it right now.
I sure hope he likes it.
Relax. Of course he'll like it.
Briar Bramble! Come on!
Who's that? Huh? Logger Vic? What's got you so worked up this morning?
Vic, you haven't gotten enough sleep yet.
Hey, he wrote back.
Really? The boy from the city wrote back?
Really? Read it to me.
Dear Uncle Vic, Briar, and Bramble, I've received your gift from the forest. I love it so much. The barbola looks great. It really takes me to the forest. It's like I'm there. With this barbola, I can imagine what the forest looks like. I can even smell it. This is the most special gift ever. All my friends love it too. Thank you, Uncle Vic, Briar, and Bramble.
It's so touching.
We made his dream come true. It feels good to help. We should be happy.
Yeah, we should keep making Barbola, shouldn't we? Letting all the kids know how beautiful the forest is. What do you say? Shall we do it?
Yes, please.
Great idea, Vic. Let's do it.
Yeah, yay! I'll do the design.
Monster at the lake.
That music's loud. Oh, it's news time.
Breaking news. A local man has submitted a photo of what they believe to be a sea monster lurking in the lake.
Monster? That photo's fake as can be.
The monster can be clearly seen here in this photograph, surrounded by large rippling waves.
Oh, come on. Someone's imagination's running wild. I bet it's just a big fish. I need some snacks.
After the sightings went public, tourists have been flooding into the area, bringing with them loads of revenue. The local government has decided to give a $1,000 reward to the villager who can capture a rare photo of the beast.
1,000 big ones? That's a small fortune. All he had to do was take a picture. And I gotta work my tail off. Some people just get it easy their whole stinking lives. It's so unfair, Victor. You deserve better. You deserve more. Oh, that smart. Yeah.
Victor, where's my lumber?
Oh, hi there, boss. I just delivered this month's timber today.
And I still haven't got last month.
Oh, you're right, of course. I'm on it. Man, I hate working. I'm such a genius. I'll just post a picture of this monster here. Then I'll be rolling in cash. Just perfect. All right. Please stay strong. Looks like I'm stuck with logging. Not meant for anything better. What was that? It's just a branch. Wish it was a monster. What a bummer. What was that? Something in the water?
I feel like a fish. Bathing in the river is so refreshing.
Bramble.
This last I was taking a bath.
It's just the bear.
Bramble!
I gotta hide. I think I'm cutting down trees here.
Bramble, are you there? Bramble!
Warren! Hey, Warren, over here!
Hi, you're supposed to be looking for Hottie for the picnic. When are you gonna get on it?
Relax, don't worry so much. It's easy to find Hottie. And as it turns out, I'm quite the expert at it.
You better be. I'll go find Briar and tell him to get ready.
Okay. Fishy, fishy, little fishy.
I gotta get out of here.
Huh? Hey, who's over there?
I thought I heard something. Huh? It's just the birds.
Oh, yeah.
I'm tired. I think I'll take a little nap. This grass is soft.
Oh, he's asleep. Now's my chance to escape. Right. Wait on. That's it. Yeah, right on.
Briar, come on, let's go.
All right,
go.
All right.
The picnic awaits.
It's been a while since we've had ourselves a good old-fashioned picnic.
The monster's ready for a picture. What a great idea. Sometimes I amaze myself. Hey!
I can't see anything. Is it nighttime already?
I'm gonna be filthy rich. Yes, current affairs. I've taken a picture of a monster.
Logger Vic found it. He says he found what?
It's at Pine Tree Mountain. Yeah, oh, it's totally true, all right. Okay.
Logger Vic, help me, please. I can't see anything. It's too dark. I don't want the monster to eat me.
Oh, Bramble, it's destroyed forests before.
What? Really?
That's right, but I think we can scare it away.
But I'm practically blind.
I'll help you. Together, we can beat this thing.
Okay.
Briar, the picnic is just over there.
I can't wait.
Oh, yeah, don't move. Oh, that's great.
Logger Vic? There. Oh, what is... So what is that thing?
Give me something scary.
How was that?
Oh, you're a natural at this, aren't you?
Bramble?
My eyes! Hey, Logger Vic, is the scary monster still around?
Yes, it is, Bramble. And it's extremely ferocious. And you need to look scarier. As scary as possible.
Yeah? I'm very strong. I'll show him!
It's Bramble!
What?
Is it the monster?
Maybe. The monster went over there.
Then let's go catch him! Quick! Come on! I don't see it, Vic! Ow! Hey, cut that out! How am I supposed to see it if you keep blinding me?
Just keep looking stronger.
What's he doing up with that tree?
Probably fell for one of Vic's tricks. I need some kind of plan.
Move over a bit. Come this way a little. Let the monster see how tough you are. Perfect.
Photo bomb!
Logger Vic, are we done? Hey, Warren! We gotta go!
Give me back my camera!
Bramble! Stop right there! Bramble, how could you let Vic fool you, huh?
Vic said that a monster will destroy the forest!
Monster?
Hello, Vic. This is the TV station. Have you got them photos of that monster yet?
Monster?
Yeah,
we'll head over and collect them now.
So that's what this is all about? Logger Vic tricked me into being the monster for his photos.
I just had a great idea, bro. Hang on just a second. Ta-da!
Ta-da!
Isn't this the scariest thing you've ever seen?
Perfect! Hold that pose! Okay?
How did I get here? I don't remember. I feel a little dozy. I slept the whole day! What happened? Come on, remember. Let's see.
More breaking news. Yesterday, a logger in a nearby forest submitted startling new pictures of the local lake monster.
A monster? That's right.
However, as it turns out, the monster is a hoax. Simply the logger in a costume. A lot of people have commented liking these photos. Some say he looks very funny, others saying he looks ridiculous, while a few are even saying he would make a terrific actor. One mystery remains. How does this logger get along with these wild bears?
You stinking bears! You pay for this!
Logger Vic is like a movie star now.
Oh, hi. We never had our picnic.
I almost forgot. Yay!
Yeah!
Survival skills. I thought it was gonna rain forever and ever. So fresh. Look at the sun. Today's a real beauty. I've got absolutely nothing to eat. I guess it's shopping time. Why is there so much gravel? Holy moly! The rain caused a landslide! Oh, well. Looks like I'm stuck in the forest for a while. How am I gonna get my food now? Huh? That's it! Go ahead, help yourself to my bait. I can taste it. Barbecued fish. Hours and I still haven't caught anything. What a waste of time. Ow! Who's there? Show yourself. Oh, an apple. Oh, yummy. Look at all those. Oh, how cute. I'm starving. What? It's the bears. I wonder what those two are getting up to.
So delicious.
Where did they get that?
Oh, yeah.
Boy, I'm hungry. How am I gonna get any? I need a quick plan. Oh boy!
What's wrong, Brad?
Nothing.
So good.
Logger Vic.
Hey.
That's my favorite honey jar!
Give that back!
Logger Vic!
Logger Vic!
Give that
get back here!
That's my honey jar!
I did it!
Logger Vic, give me back my honey! My sweet honey!
Logger Vic,
We don't see you for ages, and then you show up like this?
So hard. It's been 34 days now, and the only path to town was blocked by the landslide, and I didn't have any food left in my fridge. Oh, I tried to fish and to pick some apples, but both were total failures. Oh, look, I just wanted some honey, but this happened. But it just so starving. All I wanted was something to eat.
Bro, I feel sorry for him. We gotta help him.
All right, I'm gonna teach you some survival skills.
Survival skills? Huh? Where are we going?
Logger Vic, watch closely. I'm going to show you how to get some honey. So you see, it's easy. You just got to be smarter than the bees.
Easy peasy. Let me try. That wasn't as easy as I thought it'd be.
I think it's hopeless.
Maybe we can teach him an easier way.
Now, let's try this. Poke the hole carefully into the honeycomb. Remember, don't disturb the bees. After a while, the honey flows.
Honey. It's so sweet.
Logger Vic, it's your turn. Keep in mind, be gentle. Don't startle the bees. Hold it still. Be firm. That's right. Don't shake it. Don't shake it. Oh, no.
Help. Help.
That man is completely hopeless.
To catch a fish, you gotta be quick and sharp. Watch. Come on!
That's amazing!
Okay, Vic, you're up.
Seaweed. I got one! You're kidding me.
I mean, is it because I'm a bad teacher, or is Vic useless?
Poor little Vicky boy.
Okay, Vic, you're gonna climb this tree.
Where'd it get to?
Hey, get up here, Slowpoke.
Hey, how'd you get there? That was incredibly fast.
Keep going, Vic. You can do it.
Don't give up.
Easy, Vic.
Oh, my butt hurts.
That's it, that's it, that's it. Keep it steady.
Slowly.
Steady. Good, good, good.
You did it!
Good job, Vic.
Awesome! Oh yeah! All right, winner!
Way to go, Vicky!
Go, Vic!
Yummy!
Logger Vic, you've learned a lot.
All thanks to you two bears. I got an idea. Yeah. In order to show my gratitude, I'll utilize my new skills and get some food so we can have a dinner party.
Huh? Sounds fun.
Hey, Logger Vic, I was wondering, would it be okay if I invite some of our friends to join
us?
No
problemo.
Yeah!
Oh, awesome!
Hey, but I am can find out he's good?
Yep. He's using the survival skills we taught him.
Oh, very good.
I can't wait any longer.
Yeah,
if you don't mind.
This one is amazing.
Help yourself. There's enough for everyone. Hey, Briar, come here and have some food.
All right.
For your king.
Enjoy it, my friend.
Thank you so much, Vic.